Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytudes.com. In Photoshop, once a project is complete, there are a wide range of formats you can save your image out to. It all comes down to what the image will be used for. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss the process of saving. I'll be talking about some of the things we need to consider and then save out a couple of common formats. By the end of this tutorial, you will have a good understanding of how to save images in Photoshop. So to follow along with this video, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This document can be found in the Essential Practice folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this Project folder for free. The download link is in the description. So with the Project folder open, click Essential Practice, open the Saving folder, and open Saving PSD. And then you should have something that looks like this. So this is a document I have prepared earlier. If we look in the layers panel, we can see that this document consists of a few layers with various effects applied. We have a gradient layer casting an overlay blending mode onto the blue base layer. We have the shadow layer with a multiplying blending mode. We have the bird layer, which is a raster layer, and this has a hue and saturation adjustment layer on top with a mask applied. So a few things going on here, typical of an average Photoshop document. So currently, this is a PSD document, a Photoshop document. This being a document that has been created in Photoshop with all the layer data and effects saved. Now, should we wish to save this as an image we want to send to print, share on social media, or send to someone who does not have Photoshop to open, we will need to save it into a format that is suitable. So first, we are going to save this into one of the most common image file formats, a JPEG. The JPEG is a file format that makes up most of the images you see on the web and are also used in desktop publishing programs to create print layouts. Once the image is complete in Photoshop and you're ready to save, you can come to File, scroll down and select Save As. Upon click, we will see the Save As menu, where we will need to choose a location on the computer to save to. So in this instance, I'm going to navigate to the Project folder, the Essential Practice folder, Saving, and I'm going to save it in here. Now, what we need to pay attention to here is the Format option. This can be located down at the bottom of the menu. Now, by default, this will be set to Photoshop. Now, if we click on this tab, we will see a wide range of file formats for us to choose from. So on this occasion, I'm going to choose JPEG. Up in the Save As, I can change the name, though I'll just leave it as the current name and click Save. Next, up will pop a JPEG options menu. This is where you can toggle the compression of your image. By toggling the quality, you will be able to control the data size of your image. Notice, just under preview, we can see an estimated file size. As I toggle the quality down, this will change. On this occasion, I will set the quality to 8 and click OK. Upon save, we will simply come back into the document. Now, if we navigate to the Project folder we just saved the image to, here we can see a new JPEG file inside. Now, this image is ready to be sent via email, uploaded to social media, or used on a website. Simple. So if I open this up with Photoshop, this is now a single raster layer, and all the effects have been flattened. Great. Now it's important to keep in mind, the bigger the dimension, the larger in general the image data file will be. As a JPEG is essentially a raster image made of pixels, the more pixels making up the image, with more unique shades of color, the more data will be saved inside the file, thus making it a larger data file. So it's important to consider the dimensions of an image as well. For example, if I press and hold Command, Alt, and press I, we will now see the dimensions of the image. Currently, we can see that this image is 1,757 by 1,218 pixels at a resolution of 300 dpi. Now, this is rather large. If you're using an image for print, then it's best to keep the image as large as possible to maintain quality. But if you intend to share an image over social media, you could think about making the dimensions smaller to optimize the data file. For example, I'll change the resolution here from 300 to 72, and I'll change the width dimension to 800 pixels. I'll make sure my constraint aspect ratio link is applied, and click OK. So now my image is substantially smaller, but still big enough to see and appreciate the image. Now, if I would like to keep the image at the new, smaller dimension, I can simply press Command S, the shortcut for save. By pressing Command S, this will save the document. So now if I close the image data size will be smaller. In theory, this image now contains fewer pixels and fewer unique shades of color, thus making it a smaller data file. This file will be easier to send over email or share over social media. So I'll close the document and come back to the Photoshop document. Okay, so this time I'm going to try something different. In the Layers panel, I'm going to toggle the visibility of the gradient layer, the blue base layer, and the background layer. So now we have the bird character on a transparent background. And we know this because we can see the grey and white grid texture in the background. So now I'm going to save this image that will maintain the transparency in the background. So I'll come up to File, come down to Save As, this time I'm going to click on Format, and this time choose PNG from the Option menu. Now PNG enables us to save the transparency. So with the format set to PNG, I'll simply click Save. On the pop-up PNG options, I'll just click OK. The file will be saved, and we are back to the Photoshop document. So if we now come back to the project folder, we can see that we have a new file with the PNG extension. So if I open this image in Photoshop, we can see that it's now a single layer and we have the transparency around it. So this image will be good to use on the web or in other programs like video software, as it will maintain the transparency around. Now we could also consider resizing the image here too, like we did previously with the JPEG. If we intend on using this for web, then we could consider making it smaller to the correct dimensions and optimized for web. If we intend on using this for video, then we may wish to keep this large to maintain maximum quality. So on this occasion, I'll just keep it as it is and close the tab. So that's how you can save an image from a complex Photoshop document into a JPEG that can be shared on social media or saved to maintain transparency to be used for the web or in video programs. Now it's important to mention that if we want to save images specifically for the web, there is a feature available to us in Photoshop to further refine and optimize our data files. Later in the course, I will be discussing the Save for Web feature and demonstrating exactly how to use it. So this brings us to the end of the essential practice section of this course. It is now time to take all the skills and knowledge we have learned in the previous videos and apply them to a real project. In the next video, we will be moving into the Create a Project section of the course, where we will be learning how to set up a new document ready for our project. See you in the next video.